Hi people, you make me laugh, you lot. You really do. I'm just doing that. I've just cleaned her teeth. Sprats, come on. Sprats, it's a fish, isn't it? So, you know, she said, you can see, look. You know, right. Dried sprats. Hang on, I'll hold it by the tail. That's a dried sprat. This is a dried sprat. Okay, hang on. Would you get your nose out of it? Zed, get your nose out of it. I'll keep her over here. So they're little dried sprats, okay? And they are dry. They come in a bag. I can't remember the grammage. I think 350 grams and they're like £3.95. So I'll get a bag. Hold on. I'll get a bag of them. Just a second. Oh yes, it. All right. So you get a big bag like this. It's 150 grams for £3.50. And if you buy three bags, it's a tenner. And now, obviously, you don't use a lot of these. You shouldn't, anyway. Let's pop those up there for a minute. I'm using these for tracking. First thing I've got to tell you is they smell. They really do smell. So, you know, it's for tracking training. They're absolutely excellent. So, you can start with every footstep you take. I don't, but, you know, I started her on about every third or fourth step I took. I lifted my boot and put a tiny bit of sprat. They break really easily, so you have to earn it. Sit. Yep. Good girl. Thanks for showing so much love to Matty, great little puppy. Apparently you can't do backflip yet. Queen can't do backflip. I'm loving the sense of humour, Matty, thank you. That does make me smile. Zed's doing fine, thanks everybody that's asked. I'm going to put her on glucosamine and chondroitin. She's offering me loads of behaviours here. Oh, whilst I'm here as well, Matty, I did Google the raw dog food shops in your area. There are a lot, but I want to show you. Well, it's very difficult with Zed right in front of me. What the minced meat looks like. Let's hang on. Yeah, but Zed, come here. It looks like that, okay, and that is bone. You can see the bone. See how small the bone is. So if you're using something like chicken wings, think how much hammering you're going to have to do, which is why, you know, I mean, I pay for 700 gram tub, £1.19, okay? That's for just the ground up chicken. We thought we'd show you the basic send away and how I started training her. Can you just give me nose, love? Yes. And I will use a sprat. Sun's out, people. I've got a terrible cold, so I haven't really got much of a brain. But I'm sure you can all excuse that, can't you? Because you love me, don't you? Sorry. I shouldn't laugh. Right, let's try and get some angles. Now, the noise you're hearing is the bearings going on the fan, which I managed to get working. Well, it started working after Zed knocked the computer, but now the bearings are going on the fan, so we'll be back to square one again. We've got a lot of sun, so I'm not going to send her too far, because I need to... Zed, will you just leave off a minute? I've got the TV remote in the way. I should get more organised. There we go. Right. Hold on, Zeddykin. You just want to eat. That's all you want to do. Put your mat up here. Now, I want to reiterate something before we start, so I'll just screen up a minute. The reason I use a mat rather than a raised place board is because in real life, there isn't going to be a real place board. You know, you're not going to be sending your dog to a raised thing. You're going to be sending your dog to across the ground to further flat ground. I mean, you know, if I say place, I mean, when I let Zed off the lead, we park by a load of rocks and I say to her, place up, and, you know, she knows she's got to go to the highest place. But with send away, that's why I like the mat, because it's at ground level. It, you know, you can see what I'm trying to say. Right, stop chewing it and let's get on. Sit, come. Heel. Okay, right, now sit. Now, so you take your sprat, a bit of sprat like that. Wait. You take it over to your mat. You put it at the back of the mat, like so. Away. Set, turn. 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 Stand. There's your send away. It is that simple, people. You know, I'll go up to her and mark her. Yes. And I'm just using dry sprat. So hold on. Wait. Set here. Sit. Close in. Focus. Yes, good. Good job. Nice job. Okay, so that's the really basic send away. I'm not going to do a long video today because I can't hear properly. And I feel like a nut job. More nutty than usual, which is concerning. I've got another little shout out to do. A very young man in his mid-teens. He's called Canine Boy. I will list his channel below. And you know, all I can say really is it is wonderful, truly wonderful, to see someone in their teens who is not totally focused on females and so dedicated to dog training. You know, I would give anything almost to have an apprentice, you know, that wanted to absolutely squeeze all my knowledge out of me. I really would. But children, as young people, correction, young people, young teens are so into tech and go back, Zed, and everything else that, you know, they don't seem to be that interested in dog training anymore. I mean, I remember how proud I was because it was a total surprise when I won my first handler award at the age of 8. And, you know, it was a big banquet, it was in the newspaper, and I was just so, so proud. And, you know, it was the beginning of a lot, you know, a huge gift to give to a child is the ability to train a dog, especially if you've got a dog in the house. And, you know, I mean, my first dog, she was running the street, the postman wouldn't come up the street, she'd follow me to school, it was terrible, you know. I mean, my mother took no responsibility whatsoever for the dog, okay, but that's nothing new with her, was it? So, you know, I mean, how I got into dog training was, it wasn't safe for me at home. And a lady called Miss Richardson always found me on the street with my dog Dusty, and she took me under her wing. You know, she was an old spinster, you know, she'd been through breast cancer. I've kind of ended up very like her, you know, very on her own, and her only interest was her dogs. And, you know, she always got rescue dogs, and she took them to classes, and she made them the best they could be. And, you know, she used to pay for me and everything. And we went to a kennel club, non-profit making training group, which was the Bournemouth and Dorset District Dog... Well, it used to be the Poole and Dorset District Dog Training Society. Now it's the Bournemouth and District Dog Training Society. And I highly recommend the kennel club run clubs because they will give you a good solid foundation in basic obedience work. I mean, nowadays they don't do it in halls, they do it outside, which is obviously better for your dog, because halls, doing training in halls, it isn't realistic. I mean, you've got to start somewhere, obviously, so you start training inside. But the sooner you know, when you're taking your dog out for a walk, don't forget to put a sit in or a stand or something. I mean, when we're walking down the road, I'll suddenly say to her, left about, you know, because she's a little bit about cars still. But because she's so busy, you know, thinking, well, what's mum going to do next? You know, it keeps her occupied. I mean, so I will link below Canine Boy, and that's K9 Boy. And please go and show some love to him. It's so wonderful to see a young man with such dedication. And he is working in bite work and all sorts. And he's got beautiful, two beautiful German Shepherd dogs. And I just admire his dedication. And in many ways, it reminds me of myself, I guess, you know. And let's, you know, if we can support the young people. I mean, you know, I've said it before. us older trainers, we're all going to die off, and I just like to know that there's some nice, good people coming through. He's a knowledgeable young man, and you know, he's not an idiot, and I hope he doesn't start getting trainer arrogance as he grows. I do hope that doesn't happen, because it does tend to happen. And you know, I always say to the youngsters, keep an open mind. You can't be closed mind to anything unless you've tried it. And this is where I have a problem with people that are against e-collars. Unless you've had to use one for a very high drive dog, I don't see how you can condemn them unless you've had to use one and understand them fully. But you know, that's another subject, and it's not one that I actually want to get into on my channel. But anyway, please go and support Canine Boy. I will link him below. He's an intelligent young kid, and young man, beg your pardon, and I just admire that his dedication. Okay, thanks a lot, people. Right. Okay. Right, let's get you raving at the camera. Oh, mummy, just feed me. Wavy, 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 please like, share and subscribe. Yes.